Mimi Solomon, and I'd like to welcome you to the UNC Music Department's annual Pleyel concert. I'd like to start off by thanking Tom Keenan for donating this instrument to our music department. It is so special for our music students to have a chance to interact with this instrument, to learn about its history and the music written for it, as well as to play on and with this instrument, which was made in 1843 in Paris. And is the same type of instrument that was Frédéric Chopin's very favorite. My class, traveling through time on the Ivories, has worked really hard to put together today's concert. In addition to putting together a beautiful website, complete with original visual documentation of the instrument, they've written program notes, spoken on today's concert, constructed primary source collages, put together a podcast, a social media campaign, and so much more. Please check out all of their work on our website. Thank you so much, and enjoy the concert.
Hello, and welcome to the virtual 2021 UNC Pleyel concert. My name is Kate Nicholson, and I am a third-year chemistry major. I am also a student in Music 286, traveling through time on the Ivories. Our class has worked hard to make this concert experience as dynamic and engaging as possible for our viewers, despite the obvious obstacles that COVID-19 has put in our way. In a different time, we would all be gathered in Person Hall around the star of this show, the Pleyel piano, which was graciously donated to UNC by Mr. Tom Keenan. We are so grateful to him for the opportunity to listen to the transportive melodies that this instrument creates. The Pleyel was made in 1843 in Paris and quickly became the favorite instrument of the illustrious Frédéric Chopin. I am one of the students that was lucky enough to visit Person Hall this semester for a few classes. Hearing this instrument in person was so different from any recording we had heard. While I'm not an expert on the instrument, the Pleyel sounded delicate and mellow to me, and that sound coupled with its ornate exterior really gives the listener a vintage classic feeling. We would like to begin the concert with two of Chopin's etudes. An etude is a short piece composed with the intention of improving or demonstrating a technical skill. Chopin wrote 24 etudes, with each one addressing a different technique. While they may be technical, his etudes still retain beautiful harmonies. The etudes you will hear complement each other through their contrasting qualities. You will first hear the etude in A flat major. It has a quick tempo and a light tone, coining the nickname the Aeolian Harp Etude. This etude makes me smile with its bright lightheartedness that's bound to put you in a great mood. Secondly, you will hear Chopin's etude in C sharp minor. This etude showcases a more dynamic variation and spans more octaves. It's often referred to as the cello etude. This etude is captivating to me, with each note leaving me waiting for what comes next. Together, these etudes, while very different, create a well-rounded experience for the listener. Please enjoy.
Thank you. Hello, my name is Ryan Merritt, and I am a junior biology major taking Music 286 this semester. The next three pieces we will be presenting show our first departure from Chopin thus far. The first two pieces you will hear are the Mazurka and Tarantelle by Pauline Viardot. Viardot came from a very musical family and was deeply involved in the musical scene at the same time as Chopin, Liszt, and Saint-Saëns. She also arranged several of Chopin's mazurkas as songs. Both of these pieces feature violin with a piano accompaniment. The first, the mazurka, which was inspired by her close friendship with Chopin, starts out with a strong melody that, while conveying a serious tone, maintains a light and crisp air. The second, the tarantelle, inspired by her piano studies with Liszt, moves quickly with a rapid opening piano melody that remains throughout the piece. Unlike the mazurka, this piece maintains a happier tone throughout that is reflected in the melody played by the violin, as well as the at times exuberant responses of the piano. I particularly enjoy the tone of the violin in this piece as it remains very bright and clear. Both of these pieces should be interesting to listen to played on the Pleyel, as it will result in a sound closer to what listeners would have heard when they were first performed. The third piece you will hear is Nocturne in C-sharp minor by Nicanor Abelardo. Abelardo was a composer from the Philippines who wrote in a variety of musical forms. During his life, he taught at the University of the Philippines Conservatory of Music and pursued studies both there and at the University of Chicago. This piece exhibits long, flowing melodic lines that lend it a more romantic and sometimes sad or mournful air. However, this piece shifts on several occasions to a happier tone that evokes what is almost a sense of nostalgia or the sensation of a pleasant memory. I particularly enjoy the very flowing opening section of this piece. We hope you enjoy these next three pieces as they are performed on the Pleyel, the instrument for which they were written and on which they are best heard. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Hi, I'm Katia Carmichael, a dramatic arts senior and another music as culture student. We have three more pieces to share with you. The Swan by Saint-Saëns, Berceuse by Fauré, and Ballade No. 4 by Chopin. The first piece is my favorite, The Swan by Saint-Saëns. This piece features a majestic cello melody over arpeggiated piano chords. Saint-Saëns called this piece The Swan based on the Greek and Roman belief in the swan song, the most beautiful, final song of the swan. And this was the only piece in his Carnival of Animals he allowed to be performed in public in his lifetime. The second is Fauré's Berceuse, or Lullaby. Chopin popularized the Berceuse form, and this was Fauré's most popular piece. Similar to the Swan, this piece also features a poised piano melody over rolling piano chords. This beautiful lullaby allows us to feel immersed in some beautiful, sunlit world. Chopin's Ballade No. 4, the longest piece on this program, has several points where it builds and falls, which keeps us interested and on our toes the whole 10 minutes. I love the soft beginning, eventually cascading into a cacophony with a dramatic finish. Hearing these pieces on the Pleyel allow us to have a greater connection to the way these composers intended to have them heard, particularly Chopin, whose compositions popularized the instrument. Enjoy! Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.